Welcome to the Data Professor YouTube channel. On this channel, we cover about big data and data science. Explainer videos, practical tutorials, and Q&A session. So before we begin, maybe a little bit about myself. I've been working in data science for the past 15 years since when I was a PhD student. So much of the work that I have been involved with is the application of data science to biology, chemistry, and medicine in order to try to understand the underlying basis of the disease, how do they occur, and how to target specific protein in order to modulate their activity so that we can cure the disease. And in effect, we will try to find novel drug, and we use machine learning to try to understand the specific features of compounds and small molecules and how do they specifically interact with the target protein in order to cause the function modulation and which will subsequently cure the disease. So the data mining tools that I first started out with is a program called Weka, developed by the University of Waikato. And this software is a GUI software where we can click various buttons in order to import data, perform feature selection, normalize the data, remove missing data, and also to perform the learning process. So some of the algorithms that we use were decision trees, linear regression, artificial neural network, and support vector machine. So we initially started out as a user of the GUI software, and over time we began to become aware of some of the limitations and hurdles. We also noticed that the time that it takes to run the data mining software takes a lot of time, specifically when we want to optimize the parameters. We have to modify the numbers in the program a couple of times. And so after a couple of years using the program, we felt that we need to develop our own software or our own workflow. So the natural next step would be to grow to a programming language such as Python and R. So our research lab uses R and Python to create data mining workflow, and we try to create reproducible workflow. And we share our code and data set that we have compiled onto the GitHub so that interested individuals can download the data and the code and reproduce the model. So at first it was a bit difficult, but then over time as we try to solve problems bit by bit, modify the code, we gradually grasp the concept of programming and coding. So I pretty much tried everything from reading books, tutorials online, Stack Overflow, asking colleagues, but then as a biologist learning to code, the concepts and basic theories I have never been exposed to, such as algorithms, data structures, and all that. So what I discovered was that if I set my own problem that I want to solve, which is relevant to the research that I'm doing, then I will try to find similar solutions step by step on Stack Overflow, and then I would try to solve it, break down the problem into small steps, and then in each of the small steps try to create the code with reference to Stack Overflow and also from books and tutorials. So the thing is, I did not learn directly from the example set out in the book or tutorial, but then I used my own research problem as the basis for my learning. So for example, I have this research problem that I want to solve. So I found tutorials, Stack Overflow answers, as also specific section of books in order to solve that specific problem that I wanted to have to solve. So doing this repetitively over and over again, then I started to realize that coding was not that tough, and it is something that is attainable. And so with more problems that I have solved and that I can solve, I started to gain motivation. I started to have this sense of satisfaction that I have created something on my own and that is able to solve the research problem that I have. And being able to solve that with coding really saved a lot of time. So what I have been doing manually, maybe in Excel using a text editor, could be solved using coding maybe 100-fold faster or 1,000-fold faster. So what used to take maybe 6 months will take a couple of minutes in the R or Python code. So if a biologist like me can learn programming, then I believe that everyone can learn programming. So with determination and with practice, anyone can code. Being able to code is kind of like having superpower. If you can solve problems that used to take you 6 months or 1 year in a couple of minutes or hours, then you see what I mean.